Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. The binding of a lead or drug to plasma proteins has a big impact on the activity of the molecule. We detect drugs in the plasma. A clinician draws whole blood. The cells are spun down with a centrifuge, and the liquid on top, the plasma, is analyzed for the drug. Plasma contains water, it contains electrolytes, and some proteins. The most prominent protein is albumin. About 4% of the mass of plasma is albumin. That is a lot of protein. Leads and drugs are designed to interact with protein targets. And almost all leads and drugs show some degree of affinity for plasma proteins, especially the hyperabundant albumin. So, drugs bind plasma proteins. This is a reversible process. This binding has a consequence. It decreases the amount of free or unbound drug available in the plasma. This idea is important. Only the unbound fraction of drug is available to do other things, like interact with the target or get cleared in the liver or the kidneys. Drug bound to plasma proteins cannot bind the target or get cleared. When we measure CP, we measure the total drug concentration. This is the plasma concentration of free drug plus plasma concentration of the bound drug. So we might look at CP and think the patient has a lot of available drug. The fact is the concentration of free unbound drug is lower, perhaps much lower. There are analytical methods that determine the percent bound and free drug in the plasma. The free percentage, the unbound percentage of drug is sometimes expressed as a fraction, F sub U. Many drugs, especially acidic drugs, can have very small unbound fractions, even as low as 1% unbound. In other words, 99% of the CP can be bound to plasma proteins. That doesn't leave much for target binding. The importance of unbound fraction or unbound plasma concentration is summarized in the free drug hypothesis. Under the free drug hypothesis, if a drug's distribution is completely controlled by diffusion, then the unbound concentration in the plasma will be the same as the concentration of the drug at the drug target, whether the drug target is on a cell surface or inside a cell. If the free drug hypothesis holds true, and it typically does, then through CP, that's CP total, and the fraction unbound, we can calculate CP unbound, which is also the drug concentration at the target. This kind of information can be very valuable for predicting drug dosing. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, or leave a comment. Take care.